Hi friends, this is Anthony here. I am in Miami now. I traveled from the Big Island of Hawaii to San Diego, and now I'm in Miami. This morning I ran at 4:30 in the morning. I ran about 14 miles, got to enjoy a beautiful sunrise right on the beach, enjoyed some sun gazing as well. And this is in addition to running 14 miles earlier that afternoon. So I did not sleep last night. The night before, I slept from 5 in the morning till 9 in the morning. I slept about 4 hours, I believe. And so I'm wired, wide awake, energized. I've been living on a vegetarian life. I've been loving the peaches, the nectarines out here, the plums, the cherries, oranges, of course. Just excited to have fresh fruit here that I wasn't really having over in Hawaii. Papayas are plenty and a lot of the denser tropical exotic fruits. And some of it can be kind of expensive as well and hard to come by. Just what it is. Lychees were in season before as I was leaving. So today I just wanted to touch on a topic, not spend too much time on it, but one of the things I see all the time since I've been back, obviously I haven't been around TV and movies and media's living in a native environment in the Big Island, but it seems that every time I bring up the word 100% plant-based or fruitarian, everyone I bring that to, or they ask me if I want to eat something, it's like a real concern. Everyone I speak to gets scared. I mean, it doesn't matter that I run 28 miles in a day, or 14 miles, you know, daily, or work out, or I'm in great shape. My blood and urine lab results are incredible. It is very noisy out here, so please forgive the outside noise, the ambient noise. I did want to shoot it, so just give you an idea of what a busy street looks like. I'm not used to that. But that's why I run early in the morning, in the afternoon later, so I don't encounter that. So one of the things that I'm going to share with you is the topic of, you know, the protein situation. And this comes from vegans. I've been criticized by vegans, which blows my mind. Or, you know, not getting enough fats, you're not getting enough proteins. You know, they're buying into this fear. And it's disturbing because when I challenge back, and I don't mean to be a mean person, I have an interest in that, it doesn't interest me. Often I start by saying I'm flattered that they took time out of their day and their life to focus on me, to give me attention. To me, that's a big deal. You know, anybody on the YouTube front or during the day, if someone encounters you and challenges you and you have a bad day because of that, just twist it around, turn it around and see it for what it is. Not twist it in a manipulative way, but just see it. This person is giving you attention. And their attention, whether it be whether it seem negative or harmful or whatever, it could be helpful. You know, this one guy was talking about, you need to, you know, lift more weights, be a big bodybuilder type person. And I countered and I said, well, you know, you're more than welcome to, you know, to challenge me back. And I don't do this. It definitely comes off as sarcastic and I'm guilty of that. But I am actually excited about someone who wants to join me. It's freaking lonely sometimes running 14 or 28 miles or whatever it is a day or whatever. And, you know, also sleeping very little, eating nothing but fruits, exercising all day long, reading books, corresponding with people that are actually suffering cancer. You know, what I've learned is you don't feed somebody mega doses of protein and fats and crap like that when they're suffering from cancer. So why are we pushing the idea of the same meathead-based mentality, the same fear-based mentality on others? There's no need for it. Instead, why not go, hey, how are you doing that? I mean, how are you experiencing it? I would like to learn or share, or maybe there's something that we can both learn out of this. You know, that's kind of an opportunity to engage in a dialogue and share and grow and develop and eventually master ourselves, master our emotions. And, you know, my point is to find out what makes us human. You know, I don't like calling myself a vegan often. I use it just to hashtag to get attention in that respect because that's most likely in line what I do. But in reality, someone who chooses not to put harmful things into their own body that has been a product of violence, that shouldn't be a term. That's crazy. I mean, the term, a psychological disorder for that is pica, for putting things in your mouth that is freaking unnecessary, unnatural, unhealthy. So really, people can live on nothing but plant-based foods, and I've done it for 12, going on 13 years, the best health of my life. I'm not addicted to all these products and packaged bottled powder crap. You know, and that's what I want from you. I want you to experience abundance and know that you deserve it. Thank you very much.